sign.
I'm going to Florida. It's a very scary trip for me because it'll be my first time on a flight. Look at my hand, I'm like very jittery.
The first time I was at an airport, I couldn't get a ticket because I didn't have the right documents, and it was very embarrassing.
We're Amish, so we don't have a photo ID.
I can't help you.
But now I have my driver's license, so I know I'm good to go, and I'm very excited.
I need a ticket to the Pinecroft, Florida.
I'm not familiar with
Pinecroft. Sarasota.
Sarasota.
Oh, okay. All righty, I'll just need your ID. Thank you.
Is my ID okay?
They will do extra screening without a photo ID, so we go through screening.
Amish don't have photo IDs. They have non-photo IDs because they don't believe in taking pictures. That's vanity. And we're not supposed to be vain. And that's also a sin. And I guess they think that you can go to hell for taking pictures.
All right. First ID back. Is the gate?
So lost. Where did we go? I am not sure.
Look at that. That is so weird.
What do you think?
That's how we get on?
Yep.
It looks scary.
What if I scream on the plane?
Group 7 customers are welcome to board. Flight 5126.
They're calling my number and I'm getting on a plane. I've never been on one before. So this is it. I have to have a window seat because I need to be able to see out that window and know if we're gonna go down. I don't care. It's nothing I will be able to do about, but I need to know for my own good.
Is there anything here at the moment?
Well, let's see.
Here.
Okay.
Does yours have one?
Yeah. I was very nervous to fly, but with Fanny being so scared, I think it helped me a lot to calm down because I knew if something would go wrong, I had to be the strong one.
All right, here we go.
On takeoff, I couldn't breathe. It just, my head felt so weird. It literally felt like my head was full of air and like, I just couldn't breathe.
Oh my God.
I don't like it. I don't know what's going on. It's kind of bumpy, but I sure hope we're not going down.
Breathe, okay? You're fine, Fanny.
I was very scared on takeoff, but after we were up there, it was so awesome.
Isn't it so much fun?
Okay.
It's actually relaxing.
Like, I don't know how to explain it. Like, look how far we can see.
It was so amazing to look down and just see everything in a different way. I was flying above the clouds, and I felt like an angel in heaven. It was awesome.
You know I followed for the swan, mercy me.
Maureen and I just landed in Florida, and we're taking a taxi to her grandma's house. I'm looking out the window like, I can't believe I'm actually in Florida. I love these palm trees. It reminds me of like a book of a jungle or something like that. It's just, they're amazing.
We'll wait until you see the beach.
Maureen is coming down to Florida because she's planning a wedding, and it's just a lot of stress, and she honestly needs to get away from Danny, which she told me she needs to get away and clear her head. I'm just really, really excited to see Maureen. I hope she's as excited as I am. I just can't wait to see her. Welcome to Florida.
Hi.
Hi.
I have a hug.
Yes. So you must be Fanny.
Yeah, I'm Fanny.
Nice to meet you.
It's
okay, let's go. The others are back. They're so excited to see you.
I mean, our bedroom has two beds in, but I'm not about to have some people sleeping in there.
What if you guys would share a couch? Then everybody else could sleep in that room.
I like my privacy.
No.
The fact that Johnny and Rosanna are both Amish and not married, but they're sharing a bedroom, would be totally fine in the English world. But their families are both Amish, and the families would flip out if they knew about it. So I don't know where Rosanna gets off not sharing a bedroom with Fanny.
Hey, guys, guess who's here?
Maureen.
Hi.
Oh, hey, Maureen.
Hi, Rosanna.
How are you doing?
Good, how are you?
It's been a long time since
we've
seen
each other.
I miss you.
Oh, I miss you too. So how you been? How you been?
Good, how are you?
Pretty good.
It's nice to see you again.
I know, it's nice to see you too.
You look beautiful.
I felt really bad because everyone was busy welcoming Maureen, and Fanny just stood off to the side, holding onto her dress for dear life. All I could think of was that we got a live one here. This girl is super Amish.
So Maureen brought one of her friends.
Hi, I'm Fanny.
Fanny?
Yes.
Nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you too.
Fanny is related to Mama Mary.
Yes.
Sit down here, just relax.
She joined church.
So you're shunned now?
I will be soon, yeah.
Well, welcome to my world.
Yeah, I was gonna say, welcome to my world.
And hers, makes three of us.
Yeah.
So how are you doing, Maureen?
I'm doing really good.
What about Daniel?
Working and fishing.
So you guys still engaged?
Well,
married?
Yeah, it's just not right now. I want to wait until I'm a little bit older and I can drink at my wedding.
They were crazy about each other, and something's just not adding up.
Yeah, because last year they couldn't leave each other's side, and now she's alone and doesn't have much to say about him.
Yeah.
It's kind of weird.
Something's going on.
So where's everybody going to sleep?
I'm not sure where everybody's gonna sleep.
I'm sleeping with my boyfriend. In the Amish community, the boys and girls sleep together.
Yeah.
What? There is no way that Amish are allowed to, you know, sleep together without being married. There's no way.
In all my life, I've never heard of an Amish community that lets an unmarried couple sleep together. That's a lie. I mean, that's simply not true.
Now it makes sense why Rosanna was giving me the cold shoulder. She didn't want to sleep with me. She wanted to sleep with Johnny, and they wanted to put me in her room.
Parents and her brother Ray would have to say about her sleeping in the same room as her boyfriend.